Texas, workers in Affalterbach have been stuffing big, stout engines under the hoods of Mercedes-Benz sedans for decades, creating iconic performance cars like the ur-AMG Rote Sau, the Red Pig, a 300 cell with a 6.8-liter V8, or the extremely 1980s AMG Hammer. Until recently, most road-going AMGs have been phenomenal straight-line killers that didn't hold up as well as cars from BMW, Audi or Porsche on a track or a winding backroad. But the new 2019 Mercedes-AMG GT 4-door is Mercedes' answer to the Porsche Panamera and the revived BMW 8 Series, and we braved Austin's traffic and a rainstorm that followed us to Circuit of the Americas to see just how well AMG's latest performance car could dance. Power has never been an issue. Every AMG engine is work of art, a sweet and torquey ode to internal combustion. The GT 4-door comes in three flavors, GT 53, GT 63 and GT 63S. The GT 53 uses Mercedes' new 3.0-liter turbocharged inline-6, making 429 horsepower at 6,100 revolutions per minute and 384 pound-feet of torque between 1,800 and 5,800 revolutions per minute. The EcBoost starter generator mounted between the engine and transmission accounts for 21 pound-feet of low-end torque while the turbos spool up. The GT 63 and GT 63S modules use versions of AMG's twin turbocharged 4.0-liter V8, making either 577 or 630 horsepower from 5,500 to 6,500 revolutions per minute and 590 or 664 pound-feet of torque at 2,500 revolutions per minute. This car effectively replaces the CLS 63 and Mercedes lineup. The engine is related to the one found in the AMG GTR coupe, though the four-door model uses twin-scroll turbos with turbine wheels mounted in anti-friction bearings to increase engine response. Like the GT coupe, the turbos are mounted between the cylinder banks in a hot V configuration. In every GT four-door, power is sent to all four wheels through a 9-speed automatic. The V8-powered models swap out the torque converter for a wet-clutch setup. The 4MATIC Plus all-wheel drive system is tuned for performance, sending power to the front only when necessary as opposed to the full-time system used in other Mercedes. The 63 models have an available drift mode that sends all the power to the rear, optional on the 63 and standard on the 63S. As with every AMG, acceleration is brutal. The GT 53 hits 60 miles per hour in 4.4 seconds and is electronically limited to 174 miles per hour. The GT 63 and 63S cut that 0 to 60 miles per hour time to 3.3 and 3.1 seconds respectively. Top speed on the V8 is limited to 195 miles per hour. Launch control is easily accessible and allows for repeatable, drama-free runs. Still, none of that should be news. These cars have always had big hearts, but it wasn't until AMG starting designing and building vehicles from the ground up, as opposed to modifying existing platforms, that they achieved world-class handling. The SLS AMG was the first AMG-developed car. The GT series is the second. If the SLS was still a little rough around the edges, the AMG GT has been honed to a fine point. The GT 4-door uses two different suspension setups. The GT 53 comes standard with AMG ride control with steel springs and adaptive dampers. The GT 63 and 63S use AMG ride control plus with multi-chamber air suspension and adaptive dampers. Ride control plus is optional on the GT 53. The GT 63S also gets active engine mounts that adjust firmness based on the drive mode. These mounts are optional on the GT 63. V8 powered cars also come standard with an electronically controlled limited slip differential and rear axle steering. The GT 53 gets a mechanical limited slip, and rear axle steering can be optioned. All cars use composite front brake discs with 6-piston fixed calipers, though only the 63 and 63S have composite rotors in the rear. Additionally, all GT4 doors have active aero, with an active rear wing and active shutters in the grille. There are also adjustable drive modes, slippery, comfort, sport, sport plus and individual. The GT63S also gets a race mode, optional on the non-S. The modes adjust throttle response, shifts, suspension and steering. The drive modes can be selected by a toggle on the center console or, on the GT63S, using a very Porsche-like knob on the steering wheel. Opposite the knob, there are two configurable buttons that can be programmed to adjust settings like the exhaust, suspension and stability control. There's a lot going on both above and below the surface, but I'll be damned if it doesn't work. The GT four-door, no matter what engine is under the hood or which drive mode you've selected, is a blast to drive. Like other performance sedans, or fastbacks in this case, the car works as well cruising through rain-soaked traffic as it does weaving through the first sector at Kota. It's not the car that's necessarily optimized for either duty independently, but, like the Porsche Panamera, it does strike a fine balance between the two. The engines are explosive. The 4.0-liter revs quickly and eagerly, and thanks to the copious torque curve, there's power whenever and wherever you need it. There's little turbo lag thanks to both the turbo placement and the twin scroll setup. The exhaust note is beastly, doing an impression of an engine with a much larger displacement. There's even a small whistle from the wastegate. Lay on the power out of turn 11 at Kota and you can kiss 150 miles per hour with ease on the 0.62-mile back straight. As great as the V8 is, the new inline 6 is a real peach. We've tested it in both the CLS53 and E53, and the engine always shines brightly. The EcoBoost works magic by filling in low-end torque similar to a McLaren P1. It's nearly as linear as a naturally aspirated engine because of it. It revs quickly, like all the weight has been removed from the rotating assembly. The exhaust sings all the way to redline and exhales in a short burst of sharp cracks when backing off the throttle. For street use, the 3.0-liter might be my engine of choice. It blows the turbo V6 in the AMG 43 models out of the water, and that's a pretty good V6. Yes, it doesn't knock you into your seat from a dead stop like the V8, but there's more than enough power for daily duties. Both on backroads and on the track, the GT four-door moves with a grace that spites its sizable footprint. Mercedes hasn't released the car's curb weight, but it's larger in size than an E-Class and close in most aspects to the Porsche Panamera. Despite the use of aluminum and carbon fiber, it's not a light car.